Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you all are fine. So, are you doing your homework?
Yes.
Okay. So, yesterday we have done descending and ascending order, and you learn how to compare numbers. And our today's topics are forming greatest and smallest number, and even and odd numbers. So today our class is based on these topics. So let's understand how we can form greatest and smallest numbers, and what are even and odd numbers. Okay, so let's get started. So here, forming greatest and smallest number. How we can form the greatest and smallest number? To form the greatest number, rearrange the digits in descending orders. Means from the greatest number to the smallest number. Means first we'll write the greatest number, then smaller, smaller, and then smaller. This is how we'll get the greatest number. And how we'll get the smallest number? To form the smallest number, rearrange the digits in ascending order. Means we'll start arranging the digits from smallest number to the greatest number. Okay, so here you can see there are two examples given. First one, form the greatest four digit number using the digits 1, 9, 6, and 8 without repeating the digits. Means here we cannot repeat any digit. Means we cannot write any digit twice or thrice. We can use these digits once only. Okay. So here we have to form the greatest number. So we'll arrange these digits in descending order. So first the descending order of the digits is 9, then 8, then 6, and the smallest number is here 1. Yes. Now, thus the greatest number formed is 9861. But what if you get zero in between these numbers? We cannot start any number by zero. If you get zero at the extreme left, then exchange its place with the number on its right. Okay, means let's learn with the example here. For example, we have to form the smallest four digit number using the digits 5, 9, 0, and 3. Here you can see we have to arrange the numbers in ascending order as we have to form its smallest four digit number. So we'll arrange these numbers in ascending order. Okay. So here, how we'll arrange these numbers? According from these numbers, which one is the smallest number? 0, then 3, then 5, then 9. So here, what is the smallest number formed? 0, 3, 5, 9. But now, as we know, we cannot start any number from 0. So if we get 0 at the extreme left, we'll exchange it to the second number. Means 3 will come first. So the number, smallest number formed is 3059. 3059. Okay. So here is the exercise. Exercise 1.5. In this, we have to form the greatest and the smallest four digit numbers using the following digits, using only once. Means we cannot repeat these numbers. Okay. So here you can see a table. Today we'll do A, B, C parts. D, E and F parts you will do by yourself. That is your homework. Okay. So here, A part, the digits given are 1, 5, 4 and 2. So to form the greatest number, which number we'll write first? We'll rearrange these numbers in descending order. Descending order means decreasing order. We'll write the greatest number first. So among these numbers, which one is the greatest number? 5. So we'll write 5 first, then 4, then 2 and then 1. So the greatest number formed is 5421. Now the smallest number will be, this is the reverse of this number, means we'll write 1, then 2, then 4 and then 5. The opposite of this number, you can say, is the smallest number. So the smallest number is 1245. So here, move on to the next part. B part is, in B part, we have given 5, 6, 9 and 3. And we have to make the greatest and smallest number using these digits. So here, the greatest number among these number, among these digits is 5, 6, 9 or 3. Which is the greatest digit? 9. So we'll write 9 first, then 6, then 5, then 3. So the greatest number will be 9,653. And the smallest number will be, we'll start writing just opposite of this number. Okay. So the smallest number will be, first smallest number come 3, then 5, then 6, and then the greatest number 9. So the number formed as 3569. In C part, we have given the digits 4, 3, 8, and 7. So which is the greatest number among these digits? Yes, 8. Very good. So first we'll write 8, then 7, then 4 and 3. 8743. And the smallest number will be 3478. Very good. Now D, E and F part is your homework. You will do by yourself. Okay. Now move on to the next topic. Our next topic is even and odd numbers. An even number can be put in pairs. The most important point you can say, if we have to check the number is even or odd, even numbers can be put in pairs. Means if we want to divide anything in pairs, if we can divide anything in pairs, that is a even number. Okay. Even numbers have any one of the digits. Means even numbers have 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at the ones place. Means if you will see 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at ones place, means that is an even number. Here you can see some examples. The numbers written here are 3,458. Here the ones place number is 8 here. 8 is on the ones place. So it is an even number. 7,772. 2 is an even number. So this whole will be an even number. So you just need to check the last digit, ones place digit of each number, and you can tell the number is even or odd. If the last ones digit, ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the number is even. And what are odd numbers? odd numbers cannot be put in pairs. Means, suppose you have three candies and you have to distribute them among two people. You cannot divide them equally. Yes, you can divide it by separating half, one to each and one half. But when we talk about the numbers, if we say we have to divide them equally without separating, without breaking, then the odd numbers cannot be divided in equal parts. Here, odd numbers means odd numbers, you will find that on one's place, the numbers, the digits will be 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Okay, so here you can see the example 2461. Just see the last one's digit. On one's place, we have 1 here. Means if you find 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, then the number will be odd number. Okay. So this is how we are going to do that exercise. So let's start with the exercise now. Exercise 1.6. In question number 1, we have given circle the even numbers and cross the odd numbers. Here, we have given some numbers and we have to circle the even numbers. So first of all, let's circle all the even numbers first. Okay. Here you can see the numbers are 2356. So we'll for even number, we'll see that on one's place, the digit will be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So here that last digit, one's place digit is 6. So this number is even or odd? Yes, the number is even. So we'll draw a circle around it. Okay, move on to the next number. 7853. So here the digit is 3. That means if the ones place digit is 3, the number is odd. So for odd number, we have to cross the number. So we'll cross it. Okay. Now the next number is 4701. 4701. So here the ones place digit is 1. So 1 is odd number. So we'll put cross across around this. Okay. Next number is 6780. Here the last ones place digit is 0 and 0 is an even number. So for even number, we'll draw a circle around it. Okay. Next number is 7778. In this number, the last digit is 8. So here this number is also even number. So we'll draw a circle around it. And next number is 3489. And on this, we have 9 at its ones place value. So this 9 is odd. So the we'll put cross on this number. Okay. Our next number is 2801. In this, we have 1 here. 1 is even number or odd number? Yes, 1 is odd number. So we'll draw cross around it on it. Next number is 5433. Here the ones place digit is 3 and 3 is an odd number. So put a cross. Next number is 7505. Here the ones place number is, digit is 5. So we'll put a cross because 5 is an odd number. Next number is 4444. And here ones place digit is 4. So we'll draw a circle around it because 4 is an even number. Next number is 2907, and in this 7 is odd number, so we'll put a cross on it. Next is 9820. Here ones place we have 0, and 0 is an even number, so we'll draw a circle around it. The next number is 2132. Here we have 2 on ones place, and for one even number, as 2 is even number, so we'll draw a circle. Very good. Now next last number is 9987, and here 7 is odd number. Very good. Now you know the concept. So for odd number, we'll draw a cross. Very good. Well done. Now move on to the next question. Here, question number 2 is, write all the even numbers between the following numbers. Here, we'll do A part, and B part is your homework. Okay? In A part, we have given numbers 7 and 25. Means we have to write all the even numbers that comes between 7 and 25. So let's start with the counting after 7. So because as we have to write the numbers between 7 and 25, so we'll start after 7. So after 7, which number will come? 8. 8 is an even number. Yes. So we'll write 8 here. Then 9. 9 is not an even number. The next number, 10. Yes, 10 is an even number. So we'll write 10. Then 11 is an even number. No. Move on to the next number, 12. After 11, 12. Yes, 12 is an even number. So we'll write 12. Then 14. Then 16. 17 is an even number or odd number? Odd number. So we'll write 18. Because we have to write only even numbers, not all the numbers. Okay. After 18, which number will come? 19, but 19 is an odd number, so we'll not write it. We write 20. Very good. Now 21, that is odd number. We are not going to write odd numbers. We'll write only even numbers. Yes. Then 22, 24. Will we write 26? No, because we have to write the numbers between 7 and 25. So 26 is more than, greater than 25. That comes after 25. So we're not going to write 26. So these are the numbers that comes between 7 and 25. Means these are the all even numbers we have written. Okay. Similarly, you will do the second part, means B part of this question. You have to write the numbers between 151 and 171. So write only all even numbers that we have done in this part. Okay. Now move on to the next question. Okay. Here question number 3 is, write all odd numbers between 36 and 52. So here we have to write odd numbers only. Okay. Between 36 and 52. So here these numbers are 37, 39, 41, 43, 44 is even or odd? Yes, 44 is even number, so we'll not write 44. We'll write 45 here. Okay, 46 is even or odd? Even number, so we have to write here odd numbers only. So we'll write 47, 49, and 51. Okay. Now question number 3, B part, you will do by yourself, and in that you have to write all the odd numbers between 458 and 480. Okay. So try to do practice in your practice notebook. Okay, now C part is write any 10 odd numbers between 2000 and 3000. Here you can write any number. There are so many numbers between 2000 and 3000, but you have to just write only 10 odd numbers between these numbers. Okay. So here I have taken few examples. I have written some numbers here, but you can choose any other number also. You can write any other example also. Okay, so you can take any number, any odd number only, okay, between 2000 and 3000. So here I have written some numbers here, but it's your wish. You can write any number also, but it should be in between 2000 and 3000. Here I have written 2001, 2011, 2021, 2031, 2049, 2057, 2099, 2065, 2073, 2085. I have written 10 examples here, but you can write any number also. 2167, any number. But that should be in between 2000 and 3000, and it should be only odd number. Okay. So similarly, you will do the D part. You have to write only any 10 numbers, 10 even numbers between 5000 and 6000. So you will try to write any 10 even numbers between 5000 and 6000. Okay. Bye bye. Have a good day.